This is my jump shot.
Trash ball, I need to play. Everybody wins, let me show you how to play. When you pick up some trash, then it's a ball, and then you throw it in the bucket, you're playing a trash ball.
Bit of nostalgia for me, Rob Lang, and C4, because we're close in age.
And I'm older than you, yes,
and
I remember.
Yes, as I often pointed out.
Yes.
But we do remember Mayor William Donald Schaefer had a campaign to clean up the city,
yep,
clean up trash, called Trash Ball. Basically, there were baskets, metal baskets, mm-hmm, around the city that collected trash,
yep,
with the phrases like jump shot or
man, look
dump
like basketball
one, that
hoops,
sort of thing,
mm-hmm,
like basketball hoops, and you would throw your trash in there. He had some cool public service messages,
yes,
on radio and television. Johnny Unitas was in it. Brooks Robinson.
It was a campaign,
Vince
a whole
Bagley
campaign.
It was a great campaign. Mayor Pugh, Catherine Pugh, a few years ago, tried to bring it back, but to no avail. Is this the better way of controlling?
Absolutely. When you think about, Robert, that Mayor Schaefer did this, and to a lesser extent, but in a good way, people remember this, Mayor Sheila Dixon, back,
yes,
in 2007, had a campaign where she was on the back of trash trucks, literally as the mayor, riding through the city, and there were commercials like that. And it was to engage the community, to clean the city up, to help the citizens, the city council, excuse me, the mayor, clean up, as opposed to penalizing them, like this plastic bag ban legislation and 5 cent, it calls a surcharge, nothing more than a tax on citizens if you get paper or compostable
any
bags.
Any other kind of bag. It's basically,
exactly,
it's just telling retailers to don't give out bags, or, you know, if you give out a bag, you're going to have to charge your customers 5 cents. You can keep a penny.
A penny!
And send the rest.
I had a representative, the president of the Maryland Retailers Association, on the show, Robert.
Kelly Lucklertal.
It's 1.5 cents for plastic,
right,
bags. It's 3 to 4 times that amount to get paper bags. So, in other words, they're giving the retailers 1 cent, which doesn't even make up for a plastic bag cost, and not giving them the other 4 cents or a portion of that to help draw this cost down.
And yet, Councilman Bill Henry, telling Brian Neiman, one of the things that the tax does, one of the purposes of the tax, is to help retailers, because retailers, in fact, it costs more to give out paper bags.
Yes.
People don't demand paper bags. They won't have to buy them.
Well, that's called extortion anywhere else you want to go, but it's called coercion when it comes to an elected official. When what we're looking at, Robert, in this whole thing, is instead of a comprehensive approach to grime, at this city, that's what Mayor Jack,
sure,
Young talked about. We are selectively going after plastic bags or even styrofoam.
How is that nickel fee different from a sin tax like the cigarette tax?
None. It's not no difference at all, except they call it a surcharge. And look, all I'm saying is, let's engage the citizens. Let's make it more of an incentive-laden approach to get people. I remember when I was growing up, the Baltimore Afro-American, our oldest African-American, mm-hmm, newspaper in the country, they had Afro Clean Block, where,
yes,
they would come out and they would take pictures of your block if you cleaned it up, and it gave you a sense of pride. And why don't we use those approaches instead of gouging a working poor city like we're looking at right now?
I read into this what you may, but we approached Mayor Jack Young today on this, WBAL's,
mm-hmm,
Phil Yakubuski, and his spokesman says, too premature to talk about it because we don't know what form this bill will take once it reaches,
well,
his
if you
desk,
remember,
if
Robert,
does.
Mayor Stephanie Rawlings Blake vetoed this bill 5 years ago,
yes,
when it came,
true,
forward, and it was 11-1 support, but some council members abstained. And when she vetoed it, those abstaining council members said they would vote against it, so they didn't have enough votes to override. Here's the issue. How do we want to move forward in the city? Do we want to penalize working poor people by charging them for bags, or do we want to make it incentive-laden? I go for the latter, Robert.
Both C4 and I are going to go work on our hook shots.
Trash ball.
Trash ball. And the C4 show is back tomorrow, 9 to 1, on WBAL, News Radio 1090 and FM 101.5.